time to play.
The Rocky Hager Football Show, Friday on Channel 6.
You are looking live at Brandenburg Field, Kearney Smith Stadium in Pittsburgh, Kansas. It is a beautiful afternoon for football. It is the two top-ranked teams in the country that will draw a packed house here at Brandenburg Field today, as Pittsburgh State, the defending national champions, are here to take on North Dakota State. The program that has beaten everyone in its path in the last 10 years, except North Dakota State. It is a rematch of a playoff game back in 1990 at Dakota Field, in which the Bison won 39-29. And now today, the Gorillas are ready to break out of their cage and rumble in the jungle. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to our coverage across the great state of North Dakota. Ed Schultz along with Darren Prather and Dana Mock. I don't think there has been another Division II football game in the history of this level of football that has drawn so much attention and so much focus to this field here today. As for the field, it's really in pretty good shape. The crews have worked around the clock trying to get it ready for today's game, and they've done this game justice. The Gorillas ready to line up against a team that has dominated Division II football in the last decade. Joining me, Darren Prather. Darren, welcome aboard. It's going to be a lot of fun. You and I deserve a game like this. We follow these teams, and I think we got the two best coaches in Division II football going at it.
No question about it. Two guys that are very good, especially getting into the locker room at halftime and breaking down a few things and fixing them and coming back and doing it all over again. Two great coaches and two great programs.
Big question today, can the Bison defense contain, slow down Ronald Moore, 1,900 yards rushing, 29 touchdowns?
They can slow him down. North Dakota did a good job of slowing him down last week, but you're not going to stop Ronald Moore. He's just too tough a competitor.
And Arden Beachy, the Bison have put the ball on the turf in recent games, as it did a few years ago in Fargo. It may come down to a big turnover in the fourth quarter.
That wouldn't surprise me at all. In fact, I definitely see that being a possibility. You've got to hold on to the football. This level of the game, you have to protect the football.
Chuck Broyles and Rocky Hager will have it teed up here in just a few moments. They're ready to rumble in the jungle.
WDAY Television Sports presents the NCAA Division II Playoffs. The North Dakota State University Bison and the Pittsburgh State Gorillas. Today's game is brought to you by Norwest Banks. Also by Sellin Motors, Stop and Go, Fargo Sash and Door, Subway, State Bank of Fargo, West Fargo, FM Ready Mix, Laney, Royal Jewelers, Barnum's Napa Auto Parts, Dakota Medical Center Sports Medicine Department, ND Tax Free Fund, Acme Electric, Silverman's Big and Tall, Gateway Chevrolet, Snyder Distributing, ABC Seamless, Quality Buick Dealers, Shoe Review, PCs for You, Strauss, and Pepsi.
North Dakota State has brought quite a few fans with them today here in Pittsburgh, Kansas, which is really a tradition of Bison football. They have followed this program. This is some 30 years of football in tradition, and I don't think you can really take too much away from Pittsburgh State over the last decade, Darren. I think these two programs really mirror one another.
I think two of the most solid programs in the country at any level, no question. I remember in 1990, the first time we had a chance to really get a good look at North Dakota State, and being in so much awe of the record North Dakota State possessed over that time frame. And now you can look at the Pittsburgh State press releases and you'll start to see quite a few similarities.
Well, Chuck Broyles, 37-2-1. What a phenomenal record. The only teams he's lost to were North Dakota State and East Texas. Had a rematch with East Texas, set the record straight there. And I would think that that would put a little fuel on the fire when you get a rematch with North Dakota State.
These guys are saying that's not the case. The players will tell you revenge is not the factor here this afternoon, but come on now. You're telling me that some 20-year-old, 21-year-old kids don't remember what happened a few years ago.
Darren, the field between the hash marks has drawn a lot of attention the last few days. They've worked hard on it. It's not a great track, but much better than anticipated.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to be a factor. I really don't. You know, and I noticed that maybe there were some bad conditions last week. Let's not get that wrong. But we were playing in some drizzle. It was not a great condition, but they did keep a tarp on it all week long during in the middle of the field. And I think you're going to find the conditions are going to be as great as you can expect for the end of November in Pittsburgh, Kansas.
The Gorillas and the Bison set to do battle here at Brandenburg Field, Kearney Smith Stadium, Pittsburgh, Kansas. The flip of the coin. I think when you take a look at these two conferences and what they've been able to do and these two teams and these tough leagues, it comes down to offensive and defensive line play. I don't think a reverse, I don't think a trick play is going to win today's ball game. I think it's going to be a slugfest.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You're looking at one of the best defensive linemen there for the Gorillas, too, that number 96. And there's going to be another one of the key parts of the game. The Bison are going to have to contain Troy Wilson.
North Dakota State, a road warrior-type football team. They'll play anywhere, anytime. The Bison have won the toss, and they will receive. And I really think that many times Rocky Hager likes to defer, but in a game like this, it's number of possessions that can make a big difference. Maybe the team that has it last might win it.
Chuck Broyles has been quoted as saying that, that he really felt that if his defense could have stopped the North Dakota State offense 2 years ago,
just one time,
they could have won that semifinal game. So maybe he wants to get a shot at stopping him here and setting the tone as well. They came out of the gates. The Gorillas defense did extremely well against North Dakota last week.
It was a year ago that Ronnie West won the Harlan Hill Trophy for the national champion Pittsburgh Gorillas. And now they've got a kid in Ronald Moore, who is unquestionably the best running back in Division II football, but there's a few other fine candidates playing at quarterback. You look at Rocky Hager out of Harvey, North Dakota. Rocky just two games away from being the all-time winningest coach in Bison football history. And Chuck Broyles, Darren, it's not going to take him very long to get in that company either.
Not at the rate he's going, that's for sure. Only a few losses over a couple of years, few years. He followed in the heels of Dennis Franchione, who really set the program in place and in a sense moved on to a 1AA of Southwest Texas State, now coaching in New Mexico, a Division I program.
Jeff Wood, number 7, has it teed up at the 35-yard line, and they're ready to rumble in the jungle here. Deep for the Bison. Craig Guerin, Kyle Carlson, and Raul Sanchez. Special teams, a big factor last week against North Dakota for the Gorillas, and we're away. This will be Guerin at the 9-yard line. Guerin, who returned one against Omaha a few weeks ago, brings it out to the 27-yard line, and that's where the Bison will start out, first and 10.
Tim Wheeler on the stop for the Gorillas. The Gorillas were kicking off into a very slight win, but no less there is somewhat of a factor involved there, getting the ball in the air.
North Dakota State's offensive line, a very strong up front type football team that wants to do one thing, run right at you. The running backs for the Bison, we'll check it out. Arden Beachy, the quarterback. And open it up with two receivers. This is Hansen. Hansen picks his way outside the 35-yard line.
It's a great block there right off the perimeter, allowing him to get down the outside.
Lance Gosch making the stop and running Hansen out of bounds. Yards on first down. So important when you get two football teams that like to run the ball as much as the Gorillas and Bison do. Hansen's carry is good for about 8 yards. It'll be second and 2. They'll mark it at the 35 and a half. The Bison run now an unbalanced line to the wide side of the field. Guerin and Cahill, the two wide receivers. A 5-man front for the Gorillas. Again, Sanchez, big hole, first down, Bison and Moore. Sanchez cracks his way into Gorilla territory at the 45.
Unable to bring him down, number 11, that's Chris Brown. He's a freshman. forced to play really because of the injury to another senior player for the Pittsburgh State Gorillas. Outstanding run, though, right up the middle. This is the kind of thing, you know, Pittsburgh State was afraid of, the way the Bison are taking it right to them.
Sanchez, 440 yards rushing on the season, averaging just over 5 yards a carry, has really elevated his game the last 3 weeks. First down Bison. They'll mark it at the 45. 5-2 defense for the Gorillas. Short side. This is Beachy in the alley. Picks his way just shy of the 40-yard line.
Again, Lance Gosh getting the initial hit there, stopping him at the line of scrimmage. Beachy really impresses me in his ability to read the defense, though, and his ability to get the ball to the right man.
Darren Troy Wilson draws so much attention. A number of pro scouts have been through Pittsburgh, Kansas. Wilson, the outside linebacker, wearing number 96. He's 6'4", 245, a senior, and he's got a whole bunch of range.
They'll move him from end to end just to give the offense a different look.
Bison now with a second down and 7 from the 41-yard line. This is Beachy to Pete Erickson. Erickson out of Kenmare, North Dakota, cracks his way inside the 35. That's going to be another Bison first down.
Running right behind Scott Fuchs the whole way. Fuchs with a great block, just driving his defender back.
This sets a tough tone for Pittsburgh State's defense up front. The Bison felt like they could run the dive against this defense. And if this is any indication, we're going to have a whole bunch of yards today on both sides of the football.
Maybe a few points scored before we're all finished.
Arden Beachy has set a total offense record for a single season for the Bison this year. McDonald, the inside receiver. Cahill on the outside on first down. This is McDonald at the 25 on the quick slant. And Chris Brown, the freshman free safety, making the stop.
Looks like he's going to be a couple of yards short of the first down, maybe one or two. That was Jerry Boone, the outside linebacker, just really throwing it right over the top of his head, number 17.
Both these teams do this a lot. The down-the-line option pass, finding the seam. There's Brown making the stop, and T.R. McDonald picking up his 36th reception on the year. Second down and short yardage, just outside the 20. Beachy's got two tight ends. Five-man front for the Gorillas. Beachy down the line and picks his way for a first down. And it seemed like the running backs went the wrong way. Now, the Bison did that 3 times against the University of North Dakota 2 weeks ago. And they felt like it was an audible check at the line of scrimmage that was not picked up. Lucky for Arden Beachy, he didn't pitch at that time, which he did against the Sioux 2 weeks ago. But Arden takes the seam and gets the first down.
Also lucky that he wasn't looking for a whole lot of yards to begin with. That could have really been critical on a third and long or a second and long situation.
17-yard line. This is the opening drive of the ball game. Cahill and McDonald, the wide receivers. Ball in the middle of the field. Beachy against a five-man front. This is Erickson picking his way inside the 15-yard line for about 2 yards. You mentioned that before the ball game, that North Dakota State rotates 4 and 5 running backs, whereas Ronald Moore ends up doing most of the road work for the Gorillas.
Moore will get the majority of the work. However, there are some other great running backs on the Gorilla staff. But as I pointed out, the Gorillas like to wear a team down quite a bit. And when you've got 4 or 5 running backs that can get the job done, that's going to be hard to do.
This may be the best defense for the Bison today on second down. Let's make it about 7 inside the 15-yard line. Beachy again on the option. Mark Hansen, big hole, and he's down inside the 10. That'll be close to a first down as Mark Hansen, who is coming off his best performance last week of 168 yards, has showed up this season for 633 yards rushing. And there you see that big offensive line just really running the zone and making it happen up front.
Making some huge holes up front. That's Lance Gosselin on the tackle. The free safety again coming into play, and that doesn't mean very good news for the Gorillas.
The Bison have thrown 1 pass in this drive. This drive started at their own 27-yard line. Beachy on the keeper. Inside the 5, first down Bison.
Another good job of Beachy, just watching his offensive line create a few holes and then getting the job done all by himself.
I think you'll find both quarterbacks are very disciplined. They don't get their teams in trouble too often.
They're both very good at what they do. You know, these guys wouldn't maybe be able to play in a certain offense, but for this offense, their talents are perfectly suited for it.
Bison challenging Chance Rudzik and also Chris Hanna up front on that defensive line running right at him. It's going to be first and goal from the 5-yard line. Beachy, a decathlon champion in track at North Dakota State 2 years ago. This is Beachy, calls his own number, and he draws a crowd inside the 5-yard line, led by
Chris
Mangarelli.
Right.
What an athlete he is, and sits in there a linebacker at only 200 pounds, but he gives you all 200. There you see him, number 45, scraping extremely well to make the play and follow up.
Does just a great job of pursuit for the Gorillas to keep him contained in the middle.
It'll be second down and goal. Ball's on the 3-yard line. Beachy, two receivers to the right. Beachy, the pitch. This is Carlson, and Wilson may have a shot at him. He does!
Troy Wilson, a very quick player for the size that he possesses, is able to run the length of the field. He did a great job of just staying with the play, because it's assignment football all the way.
Well, he stopped the Herd's fastest runner to the outside. Erickson with a fine block. He gets the pitch, and Wilson, who is a pro prospect, runs down Kyle Carlson. And the ball now on third down and goal from the 4-yard line. The Bison send Cahill and Guerin to the wide side of the field. Hansen and Erickson are the setbacks. This is Erickson, inside the 5, touchdown Bison. North Dakota State on its opening drive scores with 8:37 remaining in the first quarter. And on third down and goal from the 4, it's Pete Erickson out of Kenmare, North Dakota, scoring the first touchdown of the day. Ludwig Milfors will attempt the extra point, and Erickson, who just scored, will hold.
Some great perimeter blocking on that play, too. I think Hansen threw a good one to get him open.
Ludwig Milfors. The snap is down, and the Bison take the lead 7-0 as Milfors hits on his 30th extra point of the year, and we'll be back.
World champion Billy Kidd displays grace and performance. As the Rolex Junior Skiing Ambassador, he inspires sportsmanship in a new generation. Qualities Rolex proudly supports at U.S. Skiing's Rolex Junior Olympics. The choice of champions, Rolex.
Available at Royal Jewelers, 73 Broadway, downtown Fargo.
Now is the right time to side your home with ABC Seamless. We can help cut your heating costs by wrapping your home in an ABC Seamless siding and insulation blanket. Cold will not affect our seamless siding. We can install it anytime. Plus, your home will be forever maintenance-free. With ABC Seamless, you'll never paint again, and you're assured quality with our lifetime warranty. For a free estimate, check your Yellow Pages and call us. Get world-class seamless siding and start years of saving now.
Good news for hurting feet. FootMax, exclusively at Shoe Review. Computer-crafted custom arch supports for work, dress, or athletic shoes. Money-back guarantee. FootMax at Shoe Review, Moorhead Center Mall.
Bison.
Here's the touchdown, the counter option on the goal line, and Beachy kicks it out to Erickson. You're right. Look at that tremendous block on the outside.
Took out Troy Wilson, and that's all it took, really, to get the ball into the end zone. Great job by Hansen.
This may be the best defense the Bison play all day to keep Ronald Moore on the sideline. That ate up over 7 minutes on the clock. And now Ludwig Milfors has got it teed up at the 35, and we're going to get a look at this Pittsburgh State offense, which is averaging over 30 points a game. And Ronald Moore, the Harlan Hill candidate. And folks, when you see this guy run the football, you're just going to say, why don't they just give it to him right now?
I think a lot of Pittsburgh State fans have wondered just why Ronald doesn't get to touch the ball quite as much as he can or he should. Again, now he'll be kicking into somewhat of a breeze here, so it's going to be important for him to keep it a little low and he'll get caught up there.
Ludwig Milfors at the 35-yard line of the Bison defense. This will be Ronald Moore. He will get it on a dead run to the 25-yard line. Very dangerous, and he's out to the 39.
I imagine more than one North Dakota State fan's heart started beating a little bit harder when they saw Ronald Moore get that kickoff. 2 years ago, he broke that long kickoff return there at the end of the first half to put the Gorillas on in front in that 90 semifinal.
Offensively, it's not all Ronald Moore. What it is for Pittsburgh State is Brian Hutchins, who is a Pittsburgh native who has had just a tremendous career, and Ray Staton is the leading wide receiver that they have gone to 44 times this year. That offensive line averages 277. This is going to be a motion to a trips formation. And the Gorillas move, and Hutchins is going to eat it. And that'll be illegal procedure against Pittsburgh State.
Nice 18-yard return on the kickoff for Moore, but he unfortunately caught himself going a little too early right there. I can tell you something a little different right off the bat here, Ed. You'll see number 21 in the backfield for the Gorillas. His name is Sean Scott, also a very outstanding talent. However, he's not Joey Tobin, number 22, their junior running back, who really has been starting for the Gorillas.
Well, the big story up front for the Bison will be Sean Stewart, the nose guard, up against a player who's playing that center position who has not played it this year. And also, you've got outside linebackers in Toth and Punzak, who have just had an extraordinary year, and Eric Hagerly leads that secondary with Straup and Jacobson on the corner. Israel Moses, the youngster at free safety, at strong safety. So on second down, the reverse. Here comes Ray Staton. He's got a bleak block on the outside and he's up to the midfield strike. Staton close to first down yardage. And Staton, who's got over 750 yards in receptions this year, answers with another dimension and a Gorilla first down.
Great job of selling it as well, and almost fumbled it there on the pitch. Staton played his college ball at West Virginia. He started them, was a rookie, all-rookie team for them this first year, and then came on back to Pittsburgh.
Brian Hutchins, the quarterback, with two tight ends, and Ronald Moore draws a crowd on first down. Sean Stewart, the all-conference nose guard for the Bison, making the stop. And if there is one thing that has characterized this Bison defense this year, it's how they swarm to the football. I think there's not a whole lot of secrets between Chuck Brewer and Rocky Hager when it comes to being fundamental on defense.
No, and they do preach that. Fundamentals are the number one thing. We were talking before the game, I think the two teams picked up a few plays while after playing each other the last time back in 1990 as well.
Shad Kling and Ray Staton, the two wide receivers, and they flex the tight end Sparkman. Fumbled snap, and Hutchins gets it back at the line of scrimmage. It's going to be third down and 11 from the midfield stripe. There'll be a little bit of that too, you know. They know it's a big game.
Yeah, there's some butterflies, but they're already, 9 minutes into the game already, 10 minutes into the game. They shouldn't be having this problem anymore. This has been a problem for the Gorillas with their backup quarterback. It surprises me to see Hutchins having some problems.
Brian Hutchins had some back spasms this week, right. Was in the hospital on Monday, but apparently ready to go. Third down and 11. They'll mark it at the midfield stripe. Back to a two tight end offense. The counter option. This is Moore. He's got a block, draws a crowd, can't turn the corner. The Bison run him out with Israel Moses.
Pittsburgh State fans wanting some unnecessary roughness penalty called right there, but a great job of swarming to the football by the North Dakota State Bison.
Now I would imagine that Chuck Broyles would punt this ball away and not give the Bison half a field to run after the way they handled it in the first possession. And here's Moore, who is being corralled to the outside.
There was a little bit of extra curricular activity taking place after he'd gotten out of bounds.
These are North Central Conference officials here today, the Wojak crew. This is Wood in punt formation, and he's going to put this one out of bounds. And let's see where they mark it. They're going to mark it out beyond the 20 to the 23-yard line. There's a timeout on the field. The Bison lead at 7-0. We're still in the first quarter.
Pontiac, GMC Truck, Oldsmobile, Cadillac, Mazda. Five good reasons Celand is your automotive superstore. Another reason, super deals like this.
A 1993 Pontiac Grand Am with anti-lock brakes, air tilt, and much more. Only $12,995. Just $12,995 for a 93 Pontiac Grand Am.
So shop the superstore. Celand, south of I-94, Moorhead.
Are you looking for a quality computer system that will meet your needs as well as your budget? Come visit us here at PCs for You, a family-owned local business that will not sell you a computer system bigger than you need. We're here for beginners, business persons, college students, and families looking for a new or used personal computer. There's no high-pressure sales, and we service your system right here. PCs for You, big enough to get the job done and small enough to care. We're open Monday through Saturday across from Sunmart, South University Drive, Fargo.
North Dakota State. The tradition continues under Rocky Hager. 128 wins over the last 150 games. 8 national championships and a playoff record of 26-7. On first down from his own 23, this is Beachy. Beachy works the alley. This is Sanchez. He'll turn the corner for a first down. And Raul Sanchez, playing his best football in the twilight of his career, brings it out beyond the 35 to the 37, first down Bison.
We talked about it during the break. This is really a critical series for Pittsburgh State. They really have to prove to the Bison that they are indeed capable of stopping them, if they are capable of stopping them, that is. Jerry Boone, number 17, again, the outside linebacker, bit on that play and did not keep with his assignment.
And you notice they found out where Wilson was. They weren't going to run it to him.
Nope.
Wilson, the outside linebacker who has got pro-type speed, has already run down Kyle Carlson. Bison ran away from him on that play. First down, 38-yard line. Beachy on the option, has an alley, has a seam across the 50-yard line to the Gorilla 49, and that's going to be another Bison first down.
Just running it simple football, Simon football there, taking it right upfield, and that time they did go Wilson's direction, but he tried to pick up the pitch, and Beachy exploited.
Look at the charge of that Bison offensive line. Great block on the outside, and Arden Beachy finds the alley, and what they're trying to do is get that safety up playing the run and then throw behind him. 14. No secret there. Broyles does the same thing. First and 10, Gorilla 49-yard line. The blitz on the wide side of the field. They run it to Carlson to the short side. And on the outside, there were no bones about it. They were going to bring that outside linebacker for Pittsburgh State, Tim Bradbury. We couldn't ask for a better day, Coach.
You better believe it. This is something else.
And I must say, the field's holding up pretty well.
So far, it's looking pretty good. Bradbury's a pretty tough opponent. He'll pop you if he gets a chance.
They put Ski to the wide side of the field. This will be an unbalanced line for the Bison. McDonald, the inside receiver. Beachy, down the line option pass, and he can't get it to T.R. McDonald. Good coverage by the linebacker, Lance Gosh, who went underneath the pattern, and that will bring up a third down and a plus five situation for North Dakota State.
Beachy did the only thing he could possibly do there to avoid the sack. Chris Mangarelli was all over him, had to get the football away, and basically just threw it away.
Ed Schultz with Darren Prather and Dana Mock. You're watching Division II football playoff action from Pittsburgh, Kansas. The two top-ranked teams in the nation. The defending champion Gorillas trailing North Dakota State 7-0. We're in the first quarter. This is a big third down for the Bison. Third and 6. Beachy, he's looking long. Fires down the sideline, and we've got contact, and a flag will be thrown at the 22-yard line.
That will be defensive interference. It looked to me there for a second like the North Dakota State receiver, Brian DeVries, turned around and actually tried to block on the play. I had a feeling he may have thought there was another receiver down there and actually turned around to block as soon as the ball was thrown. So that looks like that'd be an offensive interference.
It's going to be against the Bison.
Did I say defensive? I meant offensive. That's, watch the play here now. The pass is downfield, and I have a feeling that DeVries really thought there was another player down there. Watch him here, well, he didn't get far enough down, but see, he's on his feet actually blocking Duke Palmer, the number 10, the quarterback for the Gorillas.
North Dakota State will be faced with its first punting situation of the day. With 4:28 remaining, the Bison lead at 7-0, and Tate Mosier will check in for Rocky Hager with a 34-yard average, his longest. That will be a loss of down situation, and now Mosier will be punting from inside his own 25-yard line.
That's a tough penalty right there. Not only does it come 15 yards go with it, but a loss of down as
and
well.
And the Gorillas may come after it. They've got a 10 men on the line of scrimmage. Eric Perks is the lone deep back for Pittsburgh State.
The rush is
Mosier
on.
Gets it away. Perks, fair catch called for. It takes a bounce, but it is hit by a Bison player, and it should be dead at about the 37-yard line. Bison lead at 7-0. First quarter action, and we'll be back.
There's no rival against the best and the strongest. For your home, it's Eagle Windows and Doors. In every room, Eagle ideas bring visions to life. And because you want them to last, your dream shouldn't be left to just anybody. Eagle, giving vision to great ideas.
Check out the complete line of low-E, low-maintenance Eagle wood windows and doors, distributed locally by Snyder Distributing.
North Dakota State leads 7-0 here in the first quarter, and we've got quite a battle going on in the trenches. Dana, what are you seeing down there?
Ed, Darren, one of the key matchups in this football game will be the center for Pittsburgh State against Sean Stewart of NDSU. And after one series, Sean Stewart feels very comfortable. He says that Phil Shepin feels a little slow at snapping the ball. He's moved from guard to center. He doesn't feel like he's really comfortable snapping the ball. And Stewie feels, as of now, that the Bison can control that line of scrimmage.
On first down, they motion to trips. This will be Ronnie Moore. Ronnie Moore bulls his way across the 45 and into Bison territory. First down, Pittsburgh State.
Just so explosive right out of the blocks. Ronald, when he first came to Pittsburgh State, also ran the 100-yard dash, and as you can see, why.
Well, what the Gorillas are doing is they're motioning to a three wide receiver set and then coming back the other way with Ronald Moore. And if he breaks that, he's got one man in the secondary
exactly.
to beat.
And I'm telling you, this is a brand new look for the Gorillas. This is put in this week.
Well, now they go to almost a Washington Redskin formation here. This is Hutchins, who's not a bad runner, and he takes a heck of a shot. Eric Hegerly making the stop along with Chad Punzak at the 45-yard line, and that will bring up a second down and about five for the Gorillas. Hutchins, an excellent quarterback from an execution standpoint, just doesn't make many mistakes.
Brian came in for the Gorillas after breaking his shoulder in the second game. On the first play of the second game a year ago, he sat out the entire regular season and came back in time to lead the Gorillas to the championship.
Hutchins getting the play from the sideline. The play clock is down to 4 seconds. They may have to burn a timeout. They get the play off. Hutchins and Steve Hansen makes the stop at the 44-yard line, which will bring up a third down and about four for the Gorillas.
More than one coach on the sideline probably kicking his headsets right now for having taken so long. And as you said, they had to hurry that play and didn't really get what they wanted out of it.
Third down and four, 44-yard line. We're inside the three-minute mark remaining in the first quarter. North Dakota State leads Pittsburgh State 7-0. This is the second possession for the Gorillas. They run the delay. This is going to be Joey Tobin to the 45-yard line. The Bison defend it well. Stewart, Schaffner, and Steinberg in on the stop for the Bison.
outstanding job of just clogging up the middle for the Bison. As you mentioned, Hansen and Schaffner are all in there at the same time and able to just contain what's going on up the middle. The Gorillas will pound on you up the middle and then try to break one on the outside, but as you can see, there are
and now the Bison quickly going to have to change on the special teams as the Gorillas wait to the final moment to decide whether they're going to punt it. Down to 5 seconds on the play clock. It is fourth down. It's a fake. This is Ronnie Moore. Big hole. He could go all the way down to the 19-yard line. First down, Gorillas.
What a momentum turn right there. The first time the Gorillas had run a fake punt this season.
The Gorillas' first big break of the ball game comes on a fake punt. And it was a fake punt a few weeks ago that ignited the Bison defense to look for that. But Ronnie Moore goes 25 yards for a Gorilla first down. They'll mark it at the 17-yard line. They motion to Trips. This is going to be Tobin on the dive, and he picks his way inside the 15. Steinberg and Schaffner making the stop for North Dakota State.
Just a matter of picking up some yards where there really aren't. And Tobin doing a good job of twisting his body and just falling forward.
I tell you, on that fake punt, they had a great blocking scheme on the outside. I believe they pulled an offensive lineman on that.
Well, they burned me. Like I said, I have not seen them go for a fake punt, and I was looking for the ball in Woods' hand, and he didn't have it.
Hutchins has them lined up. Ball spotted at about the 13-yard line, second and five. Hutchins, this is Moore. He could go inside the five, and Hagerly runs him out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. First and goal, Pittsburgh State.
Reschke is the reason why he didn't score. While he didn't make the tackle, he was able to contain Moore enough for Moore to have to hold up and choose which way to go.
Eric Hagerly, the best tackler in that Bison secondary, saves the touchdown.
Watch the block there. Clean, let him get the block get away. Otherwise, maybe Moore could have punched it in.
First and goal for the Gorillas. Hutchins to Moore. Over the top, the Gorillas are on the board.
Nothing fancy about that play at all.
Ronnie Moore giving the Harlan Hill stance. With 27 seconds remaining in the first quarter, Pittsburgh State, and there is an injured Bison on that last play. 8 plays, 63 yards, and here's the touchdown to Ronald Moore.
Again, nothing fancy, just going over the top. Usually he leaves his feet for that play. Didn't have to in that instance for the Gorillas. Now, Pittsburgh State, when they get the chance here, will line up in the swinging gate and make the team have to play the two-point conversion. Although they could also switch back to kick the extra point.
Dr. Lee Christopherson out on the field, along with Scott Walken, the trainer for North Dakota State. And we do not have a number. We don't know what player is injured right now.
Yeah, it's difficult to see exactly who's down right there. Let's talk a little more about the fake punt here. Now, Ed, this is the kind of play that you said ignited the Bison a week ago. And it's really something that you see Jerry Kill, or rather that's Tim Beck on the right side there of Chuck Broyles. Really something the Gorillas apparently just put in the playbook this week.
And slowly getting up off the turf is Jeff Hagman, a defensive tackle at 6'2", 265, a junior out of Eau Claire, Wisconsin. And the Bison aren't real deep at defensive tackle, but it doesn't look like Mr. Hagman's going to be playing any more football today.
Terrible.
But the question here now is, would Chuck Broyles consider going for two?
He will consider it. As I mentioned, they will line up and make you have to defend that. And if the center, it's really his decision, sees that there is some kind of a play available, he will go to it.
Defensive line coach Donovan Larson for the Bison now conferring with Leo Ringy, the defensive coordinator, on just what they want to do. The Bison run a 40 package as good as any team in the country. And now they go to the swinging gate offense here for the extra point attempt.
You'll see the center over the ball there is actually number 86, the tight end, Paul Sparkman. So that gives him another option. The center can snap the ball back to the holder, who can then throw it over the middle and pick up the center.
Jeff Wood, who is 42 of 49 on the year, on point afters, and here he is again. And we're tied at Brandenburg Field in Pittsburgh, Kansas. The Gorillas and Bison. The much anticipated fourth quarter slugfest has not disappointed us here in the first 15 minutes. You know, Darren, the thing that I found so interesting about this community and the surrounding area of Pittsburgh is how into the Gorilla family everybody is. We're at University of Kansas, University of Arkansas, Oklahoma, Nebraska. They don't all take the spotlight. The Gorillas are in their own little area that really grab the attention of everybody.
Football is very hot here in southeast Kansas, and when you have to consider that until maybe this year when the University of Kansas finally broke into the top 25, they were the best football team in the state. In fact, there for a while, a lot of people thought Pittsburgh State could give the Division I schools, K-State and KU, a run for their money.
Jeff Wood will tee it up at the 35. We are tied at 7. That was an 8-play, 63-yard drive by the Gorillas to get on the board. Craig Guerin deep, along with Kyle Carlson and Raul Sanchez. 27 seconds remaining in the first quarter. This will be a short kick, and Sanchez lets it bounce at about the 22-yard line. He steps out of bounds, and that's where the Bison will take it first and 10.
Well, you just have to wonder if that was a design play or what, because Wood doesn't have, he doesn't possess the strongest foot in the world, but he's still capable with that, even that brief win behind him, to kick it into the end zone.
Bison have done a good job on kickoff returns this year. Craig Guerin returned one against Nebraska Omaha for a touchdown. And Arden Beachy, who has gone to the air on first down a couple of times today and hit one of them in that opening drive that went for a touchdown. On first down, the Gorillas line up in a 40 package. Beachy off the audible. They go to the dive. This is going to be Mark Hansen out to about the 22-yard line, and it looks like Pittsburgh State's defensive line, led by Troy Wilson, has made some adjustments to that dive play.
They appear to be moving as they're going up to the line of scrimmage and kind of reading what's happening. Chris Hanna was in on the stop for the Gorillas. We're running down to the end of the first quarter, about 4 seconds to go, so it looks like the next time North Dakota State will get a playoff, we'll be in the second quarter.
Pittsburgh State University, the defending national champions, the two Division II Titans doing battle on a beautiful afternoon in Pittsburgh, Kansas. We're tied at 7, and we'll be back.
Truckloads of garbage from out of state. Industrial waste from big corporations like GM. Out-of-state trash merchants are trying to make North Dakota a garbage dump. But Kent Conrad's fighting to stop them. Kent Conrad. He wrote the Senate bill to help states keep the garbage out, to give rural states a bigger voice in keeping out-of-state trash out of our communities. Kent Conrad, he's fighting the right fights for North Dakota.
Bigger just keeps getting better. Superman's big and tall. Better clothes, better fit, better style. Superman's has them all.
We go to the second quarter, tied at 7. And there is no question that this game is developing the same type of scenario that the one in 1990 did. Dana, what's the injury report downstairs for the Bison?
Back in Pittsburgh, Kansas for the start of the second quarter with this game tied at 7. Injury update on junior defensive tackle Jeff Hagman. In that goal line stand, he sprained his ankle. Dr. Lee Christofferson has put ice on it. They're going to take a look at him at the beginning of the second half, but for now it looks like Hagman may be lost for the game. Let's go back upstairs.
North Dakota State takes over first and 10 at his own, at their own 22-yard line. Beachy, the sideline, Cahill, first down and more outside the 35.
Got to make the tackle. He stripped Duke Palmer's grasp and just kept right on running for North Dakota State, and a nice game for the beginning of the second quarter.
They've got quite a tradition here at Pittsburgh State over the last 8 years. 90 wins, a playoff record of 8-2. And can you believe Chuck Broyles in this program? Of course, in 3 years, he's got 37 wins, but they have had no more than one loss since 1985 in any one season.
25-game unbeaten streak.
This is Beachy looking for a seam, and he hangs on to the football across the 45, and he steps his way for about 7 yards on first down.
Nice play. He again read his defenders well. He had an option still open to him. Decided to take it upfield, and why not when you can pick up 7 yards?
Well, the Bison quarterbacks over the years are taught not to pitch out of desperation and take what the defense gives you, and that's exactly what Arden does on that. He was banged up early in the season with a rib injury, and he wears the flak vest now. Missed the Augustana game, but has gone about 95% of the way for the Bison this year. On second down and three, this is going to be Mark Hansen across the midfield stripe, and that's going to be another Bison first down.
This is almost a carbon copy now of the first Bison drive of the ball game. It seems like they've gone back to this doing the exact same things they were doing in the initial drive.
Pittsburgh State defensively giving up 18 points a game this year, which really kind of raised the eyebrows of the Bison a little bit.
And it should, because they are susceptible to some points being scored against them, mostly through the air, however.
49-yard line in guerrilla territory. We're in the second quarter. We are tied at 7. Arden Beachy with a 1st and 10 and 2 tight ends against a 5-man front for the Gorillas. And Beachy will eat this one at the line of scrimmage. Excellent defensive play by Pittsburgh State. In on the stop that time, Chance Rudzik at 6'1", 250 and a junior.
A junior college transfer. Pittsburgh State uses those a little more than North Dakota State. They don't get the opportunity to redshirt players quite as much, but it was a great ankle tackle by Rudzik and his ability to just bring him down for little or no gain at all.
High school sports in this region is pretty doggone big. It didn't take long to figure that out watching your sports last night. Second down and about 10, 49-yard line. The Bison now line up in an unbalanced line. McDonald, the inside receiver, and Beachy on the dive to Sanchez, and he picks his way to the 45, picks up about 4 yards.
Sanchez did a great job of just exploding to the hole on the slant right there, and the offensive line clogged up a little bit further down, but not before a nice gain of about 5 yards.
Erickson and Guerin check into the Bison lineup on third down and 5, and this will wake the crowd up a little bit. From the 45 of the Gorillas. Beachy, the trap. Carlson to the 40, short of the first down.
Looks like Wilson again in on the stop for the Gorillas. This presents an interesting scenario for North Dakota State.
You want to talk about a coach that will go for it anywhere on the field.
Going to say that.
Rocky Hager.
I knew you were going to say
Rocky
that.
Rocky loves
and
tight end to tight end football. If we're going to play the game,
make
we think
stop.
We can do it. Let's take a chance at it. Here it is, 4th down and 1 yard. 40-yard line in guerrilla territory. Beachy. This is Erickson. Wilson chasing him down, and he's not going to get it. Big play on the corner by Joel Thornton, and Pittsburgh State has held North Dakota State at the 40-yard line.
Outstanding job of just following the ball and running to it, stopping the sweep on the outside. A lot of Pittsburgh State players there in on that stop with Chris Brown coming up from his free safety spot. You mentioned Joel Thornton from his quarterback spot. And again, Troy Wilson doing a lot of the pursuit on that play.
The Gorillas take over 1st and 10 on downs at their own 40-yard line. Hutchins, the quarterback, sends 2 receivers. Now they motion Sean Scott. The single setback is Ronnie Moore, and they go to him. Moore hit by Sweeney at the line of scrimmage.
Sean Scott seeing a lot more playing time than what he's used to seeing. I'm beginning to wonder if perhaps something may be wrong with Joey Tobin, the guy they've been going to. He's rushed for over 750 yards this year, although Scott checking out, Tobin coming back in, also taking out a wide receiver and bringing in a tight end. Pittsburgh State will tend to throw the ball on first down a little bit as well.
Well, you look at the numbers rushing for Pittsburgh State. Their second leading rusher has more than anybody else in the Bison camp, and that's Tobin with 835 yards. Hutchins, this is Staten. He's dangerous, and he's got a first down inside the Bison 45-yard line, and Ray Staten with his 45th reception on the year. He has scored 8 touchdowns this year, and one-on-one, he's as dangerous as a receiver you'll find, and that one was good for 13 yards and a gorilla first down.
Nice catch and run. Watch the spin move he puts on here. It's able to get outside and pick up a couple more yards.
Jacobson on the coverage that time for the Bison, and now Staten will be locked up one-on-one with Strout at the bottom of your screen.
Dropping back a little bit from the line.
The option pitch, this is going to be Tobin, and he's going to be run out of bounds at about the 40-yard line. That's very similar to what North Dakota State will do. They will run the option into the boundary away from the strength. Both these teams, that's a benchmark play for them.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Pittsburgh State not afraid to run to the short side of the field at all.
10:38 remaining. First half action. We are tied at 7. The Gorillas with a second down and 7 from the Bison 41-yard line.
How important, Ed, do you think it is to the Bison now to stop these guys, especially after having them stop themselves?
Well, this is a real big series. So far, the Gorillas have had a fake punt. Other than that, they have not had a sustained drive. This is Ronnie Moore, a very disciplined runner inside the 40. Down to about the 37-yard line. And one thing about Ronald Moore, he knows North and South football.
No doubt about it. Moore rushed for 56 yards in the opening quarter alone. Looks like he picked up another 4 or 5 there. He left his feet, though, and that could get him hurt eventually if he doesn't watch out.
Bison swarming to the football is Israel Moses, Matt Steinberg, and Joe Toth making the stop for North Dakota State. It's going to be third down. Let's make it about 2 from the 36. Inside, and Tobin is wrapped up at the 35-yard line. And if he gets a Pittsburgh spot, he may have a first down.
I don't think so. It looks like the refs are going to give him about another yard to go on that play. Sure, it's the same scenario. I can almost guarantee the Gorillas will be going for it right here.
There you see coming out of the ballgame, Bruce Yagi out of Breckenridge, Minnesota, who was a walk-on to this program. And Chuck Broyles, I believe, is going to call timeout to talk about a possible conversion attempt here on fourth down. We're tied at 7, and we'll be back.
You know, I cannot believe the changes going on in local banking. I mean, first this, first that, this name to that name. I mean, there is so much confusion. There's no confusion over at State Bank of Fargo and State Bank of West Fargo. I've checked it out. They've got the best rates, hours, service, and locations. You ought to do what everybody else is doing. Move your accounts over to State Bank of Fargo and State Bank of West Fargo. And the good news is there's not going to be any change. They're locally owned neighborhood banks.
If this car doesn't start, I'm gonna be late. I'd better do something before the weather really gets cold. Right away, I thought of Farnam's Napa Auto Parts. I've told them I've been busy lately and just haven't had time to worry about my car. They told me I should get a quality Napa engine heater, now on sale for just $12.99. Don't get stopped short. Get a Napa engine heater at Farnam's and participating service outlets.
Pittsburgh, Kansas, the site of this NCAA Division II quarterfinal matchup between the two top-ranked teams in the nation. And the Bison, one improvement they've had from last year to this year is their sacks and will development. Here's a fourth down conversion attempt. And Ronald Moore inside the 35, and I believe that's going to be enough for a first down. You know, Darren, the sack attack for North Dakota State, that is one area that has been really improved on. Over a year ago, where they had only 17 sacks, this year were 31, but
And it's
maybe that stat's not going to play out here today because both teams will slug it between the tackles.
You're absolutely right. I see maybe each team getting one sack at all this entire game. They just don't drop back and pass, neither team.
First down and 10. Moore on the conversion attempt on fourth down. Puts the ball now at the 33-yard line of North Dakota State. Brian Hutchins, this is Moore, pops his way just shy of the 30. Matt Steinberg is there out of his linebacker spot along with Paul Schaffner.
I wouldn't be at all surprised to see Pittsburgh State go into a tight end here in this next few plays. They throw a little slant pattern over the middle and it tends to catch teams a little off guard in this corner of the field.
Well, your tight ends on the year, you've got Scott Lutz with 7 receptions and Paul Sparkman with also 7 receptions. They don't go to him too often.
Nope.
Second down and 7. Hutchins, Staten hangs on to it at the 25. Like, Staten wanted to run before he caught it.
Staten's done that once or twice this year, but that does go for a nice gain for the Gorillas. Let me pass along a couple other scores as you take a look at the replay. Staten having a little trouble bringing the ball in. Sees the defender and then concentrates on his business at hand. New Haven, Connecticut, leading Ferris State of Michigan 28-6 in the fourth quarter. And Jacksonville State of Alabama out of the South region up on North Alabama down in Florence by the score of 14-6 in the second frame.
Third down and 1 from the 29. Moore on the carry, first down Gorillas. There's a flag down. It could be a face mask. That will be the first penalty against the Bison defense here today.
That'd be the second penalty of the game. The Gorillas whistled for a motion penalty on their first play from scrimmage. That is indeed the call from the referee and an unintentional face mask, so it'll be a 5-yard pickup for the Gorillas and a first down. See if we can get a good idea of where it came from here. Moore crashing into the line, not looking for a big gain. And looks like maybe a little bit of pulling underneath his gym strap right there.
Schaffner, the linebacker, along with
some good
Israel Moses making the stop for the Bison. Now it's going to be first down. They'll mark it at the 17-yard line. First and 10, the Gorillas knocking on the door. We're tied at 7. Second quarter action. They motion to Trips. Moore, the single setback. This is going to be Hutchins on the keeper, and Hutchins goes to the 5. Let's make it the 10-yard line. And that's where Hutchins is very dangerous. He comes into today's game with over 700 yards rushing and averaging just shy of 4 yards a carry.
You know, you're looking at a mirror image here of Avicii. The two of them have the same numbers almost exactly through the first part of the season. Want to make a correction before we go any further. That was the third penalty, the second against the Bison. They were called for that one offensive pass interference earlier in the contest.
They'll mark the ball now at the 11-yard line. A pickup of 6 by Hutchins. He's got 2 tight ends, Staten the wide receiver. On the pitch, this is Ronald Moore, and Moore is tripped up at the 10-yard line, and an injured Bison there. I believe that's Eric Hegerly, who
two weeks ago
hurt his neck and has been wearing a neck brace, and I believe he's got it on today, and he gets up a little slow. Eric Hegerly, who is a preseason All-American candidate, has had just a remarkable season this year. And this is really a young Bison defense. This is not an old Bison team by any stretch of the imagination. They've got a lot of players coming back next year. In fact, many people thought it was quite an accomplishment that this team was able to come this far. And now, Troy Mickelson, a senior, fifth-year senior, will jump in at free safety for the Bison.
Hegerly did a great job of stopping the play there. He tripped Moore up and very, very well could have stopped the touchdown.
It is third down and about 1 from the 8-yard line. This is Moore, and he got the first down at the Bison 5-yard line.
Just straight ahead football, 3, maybe 2 yards in that case, and a cloud of dust.
6:15 remaining in the first half. We're tied at 7.
Both teams taking a lot of time off the clock, as you would expect from a couple of running offenses. Moore's jersey starting to get a little ripped up. Sure, he's beginning to feel that onslaught.
North Dakota State digs in. It's first and goal from the Bison 5-yard line. Tobin back in the lineup with Moore in the backfield, Hutchins at quarterback. They run the dive. This is going to be Moore, and he's inside the 5-yard line. Picks up about 3. And this will bring up a second down and goal. These are two of the most disciplined football teams up front that you can find at this level of football.
No doubt. They're both very assignment-oriented. I know I keep going back to that, but nobody really breaking down anyway. I remember a couple of years ago when we played North Dakota State, the Bison had given up a rushing touchdown, and it seemed like 20 centuries there for a while. Let's see how tough
Kling
they are right
and
now.
Staten to the wide side of the field. That's Scott in motion. Ronald Moore, the setback. This is going to be Hutchins, and he's short of the goal line. He got 6 yards the last time they ran that, out about the 15-yard line. But closing down quickly was Sean Stewart, the nose guard. And also on the outside for North Dakota State was Greg Nelson.
Tell you what they're doing here, Ed. Now, they move Scott in motion to set up that triple option or triple receivers, but they're also negating one of the options available to Hutchins that close to the end zone. This is a very different look for Pittsburgh State. I'm sure they're trying to confuse Coach Hager and the rest of his staff.
Well, they're trying to get the secondary playing over so they can pop the dive away from the string.
Now we've got just your basic Vera formation.
Third down and goal from the 1-yard line. Hutchins to Moore, and I don't think he got in. It's going to be fourth and goal. The Bison hold inside the 1-yard line. It's tough sledding in there. Again, Sean Stewart making the stop along with Brian Sweeney and Joe Toth.
Keeping an eye on the Pittsburgh State coaches right now. They haven't made a decision. Looks like they're going to call a timeout and talk about it.
They are going to use a timeout. And that shows you how much respect they've got for North Dakota State. They've got 6 inches to go for a touchdown, and they call timeout. We're tied at 7, and we'll be back.
No negotiating necessary. That's right. Gateway Chevrolet Geo is having a 34-hour used car, truck, and van inventory disposal sale. And there's no negotiating necessary. Over 200 used units, all marked for final disposal. Monthly payments are clearly marked on the windshield of every vehicle. You simply pay $59 down and drive home a vehicle of your choice. Bring your trade to get top dollar. $59 down delivers with approved credit. Plus, we're open extended hours Friday, Saturday, and Monday, all till 8 p.m. Only at the area's largest used car and truck dealer, Gateway Chevrolet Geo in Fargo.
You've done all your homework. You've done your field work. Now, all the planning, sweat you've invested will be multiplied or diminished by a single input, the seed. Golden Harvest.
That's how far away Pittsburgh State is from taking the lead here at Brandenburg Field, Kearney Smith Stadium in Pittsburgh, Kansas. With 4 minutes and 4 seconds remaining in the first half, we're tied at 7. It's fourth and goal. The Gorillas to Moore over the top. Touchdown, Pittsburgh.
Very good leaper, just going airborne and getting what it takes to score the touchdown for Pittsburgh State.
The swinging gate again, and Jeff Wood to attempt the extra point. 16 plays, 59 yards, and Ronald Moore scoring his second touchdown on the day, giving Pittsburgh State the advantage at 13-7 with 4:01 remaining in the first half. And Jeff Wood, 43 of 50 on point after attempts this year, makes it 14-7. The Gorillas have taken the lead here at Brandenburg Field in Pittsburgh, Kansas.
Here's the play again. Moore getting the handoff just right up and over the middle. Good job of penetration by the Gorillas offensive line. Didn't have to get a whole lot in. He didn't, but he did get the score. And Chuck Broyles looking pretty good right now with 4 minutes to go here in the second quarter.
Well, Chuck Broyles has very little to do with the Gorilla offense. Mm-hmm. His roots are defense. He's been a defensive coach for most, if not all, of his career. Was at Missouri Rolla, had a very successful run there. Was an All-American player here at Pittsburgh State back in the 60s. Had a run with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and if I remember correctly, that was kind of a tough time to break in with the Steelers.
I would imagine so. Jerry Kill is the offensive coordinator for the Gorillas. He started here about 6 or 7 years ago as the linebackers coach, left to go be the head high school coach at Webb City High School in the area, led them to a state championship, came back as offensive coordinator, and incidentally, the Webb City High School football team under a former Gorilla linebacker now won the state championship in Missouri 4A just yesterday. You were talking a little bit about the Bison ability to return the kick. I've got a feeling this kick probably will be pooched a little bit and kept on the ground.
Well, it was a very good decision the last time that Burke kicked off because he put it out of bounds at the 22-yard line with Raul Sanchez on the receiving end of it. And now they're going to try an onside kick.
No, they'll be kicking it up.
They'll try one side, Dan Reschke, at his own 31-yard line. So the Bison, again, missing another opportunity to return a kick with 4:01 remaining in the first half. We'll go back on offense, trailing Pittsburgh State 14-7. We have yet to see a turnover in this football game. And the turnover margin for both football teams is obviously on the plus end of things. The Bison plus 5 and the Gorillas an amazing plus 19 in the turnover column.
And a lot like North Dakota last week, they're very opportunistic when they get the turnover to turn it into points.
First down for Arden Beachy. Ball's at the 32-yard line. They've got three defensive backs on the wide side covering the two wide receivers, and on the dive play, they get it out just shy of the 35-yard line, and Mark Hansen, the ball carrier, who you see Donovan Larson, the defensive line coach for North Dakota State.